Hey, I'm Theresa, and I will show you how to carry out the commissioning of our digital free chlorine sensor MemoSense CCS51D. With the CCS51D, you can reliably measure free chlorine in different water applications. Thanks to the MemoSense technology, the sensor comes pre-calibrated and is ready to use just with plug and play. With the CYK10, you have a ready-made configured cable, which is identical for the whole MemoSense sensor platform. This guarantees an easy startup. The basic CYK10 cable version is available with wire terminals on the transmitter side. Optionally, a version with M12 plug is available. On the sensor side, you have the MemoSense Bionet plug for easy connection. Attach the exposed cable shield to the crowning clip by using an appropriate cable clamp. Make sure the cable mounting rail of the CM44 is properly grounded. Thanks to the color-coded wires, the connection is very easy. Before installing the sensor into the process, please remember, always wear your personal safety equipment, safety glasses and chemical-resistant gloves. The sensor is fitted with a protection cap for best storage conditions. This cap has to be removed for commissioning. First, open the top part of the protection cap by turning it counterclockwise. After that, carefully remove the protection cap from the sensor. Don't remove the sensor from the protection cap without opening the top part first. This could damage the sensor membrane. The sensor needs a certain flow against the membrane, and therefore it must be installed into one of the following assemblies. It must be installed in the FlowFit CYA27, or alternatively, it can be installed in the FlexTip CYA112 on one of the previous assemblies, FlowFit CCA250 or FlowFit CCA151. For each assembly, a different mounting adapter is necessary. The correct adapter must be chosen in the order code of the CCS51D. First, let's take a look at the installation into the FlowFit CYA27. Remove the blind plug from the CYA27 assembly and insert the sensor. Screw the coupling nut onto the assembly. Mounted in this flow assembly, the flow weight must be at least 5 liters per hour or 30 liters per hour, depending on the CYA27 version. Adjust the flow weight with the needle valve at the inlet module while the outlet valve is constantly open. For installing the sensor into the CYA112, using the quick fastener is recommended. Installed in this assembly, the flow velocity against the membrane must be at least 15 cm per second. For installation into the CCA250, remove the blind plug from the flow assembly and insert the sensor. Screw the adapter onto the assembly. Mounted in this assembly, the flow rate must be at least 30 liters per hour, which means above the red mark. Adjust the flow rate with the needle valve. For installation into the FlowFit CCA151, remove the blind plug from the CCA151 assembly and insert the sensor. Screw the coupling nut onto the assembly. Mounted in this flow assembly, the flow rate must be at least 5 liters per hour. As the free chlorine measurement is pH dependent, a pH compensation is recommended if the fluctuation of the pH value in water exceeds plus minus 0.1 pH. In this case, use the flow assembly FlowFit CYA27 or the former CCA250. They are designed to accommodate all sensors needed for accurate disinfection measurement and control. For disinfection applications in drinking water, the CPS 31E with salt ring is recommended. Now let's start with the polarization of the CZS51D. Therefore, apply power to the CM44 and the connected sensor starts to polarize. This takes up to 60 minutes. In the meantime, further settings can be configured in the Liquiline transmitter. A most important setting for free chlorine measurements is the pH compensation. In case a pH compensation is required, which is in the majority of the free chlorine applications, don't miss to set it up in the Liquiline menu. To assign the measured pH value for compensation, go to Menu, Setup, Inputs, and select the input of the disinfection sensor CZS51D. Afterwards, go to Extended Setup and scroll down to Medium Compensation, pH. Per default, the pH compensation is on and related to the fixed value of pH 7.2. This is shown by the hand symbol on the measurement screen. To use the value of the installed pH sensor for compensation, go to Compensation Mode and select Measured Value. Scroll down to the sensor selection and assign the respective pH sensor from the sensor selection. A second very helpful feature is the electrolyte counter. It is applied by all of our disinfection sensors. Once activated during commissioning, the consumption of the electrolyte in the sensor membrane cap can be monitored over time. If a warning limit is reached, a warning message ensures that the electrolyte can be exchanged in time. To enable the electrolyte counter, please go to Menu, Setup, Inputs, choose the free chlorine channel and go to Extended Setup and enter the diagnostic settings. Scroll down to electrolyte counter. Activate its function and set the required warning limit according to your individual predictive maintenance planning. Per default, the warning message appears when 80% of the electrolyte capacity is reached. To read out the actual electrolyte consumption, check the charge given by the sensor information in the diagnostic menu. As the factory calibration for the CZS51D and the pH sensor is stored in a MemoSense head, the sensors are ready for operation now. And you are finished with commissioning. Wasn't that easy? Thanks for watching. Follow Andresen Hauser to see more of our productions. And if this video was helpful, like it.